Hi guys, it's Christian for Digital DJ Tips, and today we'll be taking a look at the new and improved beaTunes 5 app. So beaTunes is an app for Mac or PC that helps you improve, correct, update and manage your music files. It analyses your tracks to give you accurate information regarding the tempo, key, mood, danceability and much more. It aims to take away the stress of manually processing a huge number of tracks, and it does so with just a few clicks. We've reviewed beaTunes 4 before, and today we're going to be taking a look at what's new in beaTunes 5.
So, here we are inside the beaTunes 5 app. Now, as you will know, this comes with a free trial, that's 14 days, and you get pretty much all the features. There are some that aren't included, which I will move on to later. Now, this is the library view, and it does look quite familiar. It looks quite like iTunes. You've got your player at the top here, your volume controls and whatnot. You get your tabs at the side. These are in Russian, but it's just the same in English, I'm sure. Music, films, and TV shows. Tabs at the side, library, analysis, inspection, and charts, which we'll move on to shortly. And as you can see here, these are all the tracks. Now, I've analysed and imported my library before we started this review, but I will just show you how the analysis part works. What you do is you, to show you as one example, you right-click and press Analyse, and you'll be given this analysis options box. Now, one thing I didn't know before I analysed my stuff was that I didn't realise you had to opt into these analyse key, determine colour, estimate mood things. So I had to reanalyse my entire library, which cost me a few hours, but that's by the by. I wish I would have known earlier. And that's why I think it would be useful to have a setup wizard when you first open this, so you wouldn't miss these things. Anyway, if I show you now how analysis works, you press that, it gets added to the task queue, go to the analysis tab, and it will start to analyse it. Now we can see here you'll end up with the key, the colour and the mood, which we already had, the danceability and whatnot. It takes some time, but then afterwards you're left with a full library with all this information here, which is brilliant. It shows you how danceable the track is, the colour, the keys, as you said, and even how you can transition from different genres, from rap to hip-hop, from rock to country, whatever you want. The different moods here, fantastic. That really is useful. The second part really here on the side is this inspection one. Now when you first analyse your entire library, it will show you what kind of issues you've got. For example here, you've got same artist, different genre, you've got spelling mistakes there, you've got some artwork missing from one of the tracks in an album, and it will fix all those things from you. Now this is one of the things that is not available straight away in the trial version. You'd have to purchase the full version for it to make those fixes for you. So moving on to the charts section, Amazon is automatically linked with beaTunes 5. You've got the whole music chart here, and it will, if you just hover over it, it will say, look, number one is Despacito featuring Justin Bieber. And it's the same here with all the rest of them. That's the top 100. Now, one of the really cool things here is with Beatport. beaTunes 5 has integrated with itself with Beatport. Now, to do that, what you'll have to do is you go into settings at the top here, and where it says Beatport, establish a connection with Beatport. It'll pop out into your internet browser. You log into Beatport and it will synchronize the two together, which is brilliant. Now, then you can have a look here in the charts, just the same way as you did with Amazon. It'll take a bit to load because it's dependent on your internet connection, of course. And there you go, we've got the top 100 hip-hop R&B charts. Same goes for all the different genres, really cool. But one of the best features, especially for DJs with Beatport, is if we go back to the library, it doesn't really matter what we choose here. We can pick something with a decent BPM, let's say 120, that should find something. So when I click that, it automatically shows me here now, as I've already selected it, new releases for minimal with similar BPM. And it's found all the tracks in the chart there with 120, 121. And you've got lots of different rule sets you can look for here. BPM, colour, matching BPM and colour, you can choose between them and it will help you find different tracks, which is really useful if you're digging for tracks. You know, you can find something you might not ordinarily would have even looked at, never mind found, which is great. And there's another important update as well with beaTunes 5, and that's the sync button here, and that will change the key and show you if, for example, we played a track that's 125 at 120 as Saturday Night Special is here, it will show you what key it would be without key lock on, if that makes sense, if it was sped up to the or sped down to the same tempo. It really is cool. And the other one that I'd like to show you as well is about making playlists. If you right click here and you can go from new match list here, let's say for example you've got your tune there, you can select as many as you want, press OK, and it'll automatically create a playlist here of all different tracks with similar stuff that you can just have it playing, and that's that can be really useful. Now, if we just go back again to library. Okay, so another thing I wanted to show you was this radio mode that they've got. So if you click a track here, right click, play similar songs, the track will start and it will start to search for you. And when that goes off, you can just leave it then and it will play. The next track we've got here has come up, Notorious B.I.G., next one, Massive Attack, Left Field, even The Orb, there we go, brilliant. So and it will do that and it will just play for you, which is great. It means that you don't have to get up and keep changing stuff. It should pick pretty similar stuff or entertaining stuff anyway. A nice selection as opposed to just getting stuck in a list and you know, someone's got to change it all the time, which is, I think it's a really good feature. So, to round up, I really think that beaTunes 5 is a useful tool for those who have an untamed library, especially DJs, because it offers so many analysis options. Like we've said before, you've got your key, you've got your colour, your danceability, transitions from different genres, mood. It's great. And then the way it's linked with beatport as well makes it an extra specially interesting and useful tool. You know, it makes digging so much easier. So much easier. I think that really is great. And if you're already a beaTunes 4 user, then the upgrade to this as well is $11. And I would say that it's certainly worth it. I think a lot of work's gone into this. And yeah, I would definitely recommend it if you already are a user. I would have given this a 5 stars. The only thing that's preventing me from giving it 5 stars is the fact that it lacked a setup wizard. That really, really would have been a useful addition.
If you've enjoyed this review, give it a thumbs up and hit the subscribe button below if you're not already a subscriber. This was Christian for Digital DJ Tips. Cheers for watching and I'll see you soon.